Trump heads to the Republican National Convention in Milwaukee. Republicans will formally nominate him for president a day after an assassination attempt that further inflamed an already bitter U.S. political divide. Security is tight in the state in the aftermath of Saturday's shooting in Pennsylvania. The Secret Service also assures Americans adequate measures are in place to secure the event.
This is a national special security event. That designation is the highest level of security designation that the federal government can determine. So we are confident in the security plans that are in place for this event, and we're ready to go. It's been an 18-month process. We've worked together over that 18 months to develop operational security plans for any and all aspects of security related to this event.
But did it change within the last, has any change been made in the last 24 hours?
We're not anticipating any changes to our operational security plans for this event.
The Republican National Convention kicks off Monday, July 15th. An update on the deadly campaign shooting in Pennsylvania gripping the world. The Federal Bureau of Investigation says the suspected gunman in the assassination attempt of Donald Trump acted alone and used an AR-style rifle that was purchased legally. The FBI says the investigation is still at its early stage, and they have yet to identify the motive of the suspect, Thomas Crooks. The gunman is a 20-year-old resident of Bethel Park. Some of his schoolmates described him as an outcast who was bullied in high school.
I didn't have any interaction with him, but he was a kid that was always alone. He was always bullied. I mean, he would sit alone at lunch. I mean, he was just an outcast, and you know how kids are nowadays, so they're going to see someone like that and they're going to target him because they think it's funny or whatever. So it's the best way I can describe it. And it's honestly kind of sad. Like, I don't want to say this is what provoked it, but you never know.
Crooks was shot and killed by the Secret Service seconds after he fired shots towards Trump, who was grazed by a bullet. He was a registered Republican who would have been eligible to cast his first presidential vote in November. Trump supporters gather near his Mar-a-Lago estate in Florida to rally behind the former president. Saturday's incident plunged the 2024 U.S. presidential race into a new level of shock and uncertainty. There are also fears the shooting could change the race violently.
To me, we are human beings. Nobody wants to get killed. That assassination is for the low-life scum people. Evil. No one, the President Biden, does he want to somebody shoot him like that? No. President Trump not deserve that. He's trying to help American people to have a better life.
First things came to mind was Kennedy. Second thing was Reagan. All the things that every president that has tried to do something positive, somehow something drastic happens to them. And when I saw that to Trump, when he went to his face like that, I said, oh my God. And there was a shot to the head. It wasn't just something to scare him off. It was something to put him off. So I really was very upset about everything.
Over in New York, supporters also gathered outside the Trump Tower, waving giant flags with the former president's image on them. U.S. President Joe Biden calling for unity a day after the assassination attempt on his Republican rival. During his address at the White House, Biden also sent his condolences to the family of the 50-year-old man who died in the shooting. He asserts violence has no place in America. He also vows a thorough and swift investigation into the incident.
Last night, I spoke with Donald Trump. I'm sincerely grateful that he's doing well and recovering. And we had a short but good conversation. Jill and I are keeping him and his family in our prayers. We also extend our deepest condolences to the family of the victim who was killed. He was a father. He was protecting his family from the bullets that were being fired. An assassination attempt is contrary to everything we stand for as a nation, everything. It's not who we are as a nation. It's not America. And we cannot allow this to happen. Unity is the most elusive goal of all, but nothing is important than that right now, unity. We'll debate and we'll disagree. That's not going to change, but we're going to not lose sight, in fact, who we are as Americans.
Pennsylvania Governor Josh Shapiro speaking out following the assassination attempt against Trump in his state. Shapiro, a Democrat, says political disagreements should never be addressed through violence. He urges the leaders on both sides to speak up and further supporters to remember that they are all Americans.
This is a moment where all leaders have a responsibility to speak and act with moral clarity, where all leaders need to take down the temperature and rise above the hateful rhetoric that exists and search for a better, brighter future for this nation. My message to all Americans is to be firm in your beliefs, to believe what you believe, to advocate for what you believe, and to be engaged in the political and civic process, but to always do so peacefully. To remember that while we may be Democrats or Republicans, above all else, we are Americans.
A political analyst also urging unity among politicians across party lines. Robert Pape, director of the Nonpartisan Chicago Project on Security and Threats, conducted a survey 2 weeks ago on a potential second Trump presidency. It found 10% of American adults support the use of violence to prevent Trump from becoming president, while 7% support violence to restore Trump to the presidency. Pape stresses both sides need to take action to address the acceptance of political violence in the mainstream.
So you're getting incredibly angry politics, and that's making people angry. And then that is encouraging the anger to turn to violence. And this is, hurt by the fact that politicians from all sides, they have no problem blaming the other party for violence. So you have no problem with Republicans blaming Democrats for violence against Republicans, and no problem with Democrats blaming Republicans for violence against Democrats. But there's a lot of hesitation to criticize their own constituencies. We're now at a tipping point. There is a potential for this whole thing to spiral now that we've passed this threshold. And this is the time to come together against political violence.
Philippine President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. among the world leaders who have condemned the assassination attempt against Trump. Marcos says those who love democracy must condemn all forms of political violence, adding the voice of the people must remain supreme. Ukrainian President Volodymyr Zelensky says there is no justification for such violence. He also wishes America will emerge stronger from the incident. British Prime Minister Keir Starmer echoing their sentiments and says his thoughts are with the victims of the attack. Israeli Prime Minister Benjamin Netanyahu wishing Trump a quick recovery as he denounced what he called an attempt to assassinate American democracy. Australian Prime Minister Anthony Albanese also saying there is no place for such violence, regardless of one's political views.
In Australia, as in the United States, the essence and the purpose of our democracies is that we can express our views, debate our disagreements, and resolve our differences peacefully. We do so with respect for each other and in the spirit of a shared love of our country. Any act of violence is an affront to that and must be condemned unequivocally. This was an inexcusable attack on the democratic values that Australians and Americans share and the freedom that we treasure. Political issues, this isn't a day for politics. This is a day to unite, to express our concern, regardless of one's political views.